How's it going, everybody? Rebel Marksman here. Welcome back to the channel. We're going to be taking another look at Rising Storm Vietnam, and we're going to spend another day at the range. But this time, we're going to be looking at the NVA faction, and we're going to start off with the Guerrilla class. Now, as you can see here, we get equipped. Holy crap. I didn't realize you guys could, or we could take these rifles. AK-47 is the basic. The SKS 45 carbine, which is a Chinese copy. Actually, the AK-47 and the SKS 45 are all Chinese copies of the weapons. I may be absolutely wrong, but I'm pretty sure that that's what it is. You can see we are equipped with the Type 67 stick grenade as well as a bungee trap. So let's take a look at this up here in the tower again. Let's get back down here to the range. You can see run with the weapon in one hand as well for the not the axe as the axis used to in Red Orchestra. All right, you can see we've got the hooded post, which I believe makes it the Chinese pop. Recoil is more than the M16 is, but less than the M14 because this is an intermediate 7.62 by 39 cartridge. It's very controllable and very beefy, and you will see that you will quickly outgun the Americans using this type rifle. And that was the case such that in real life, it was a pain in the ass to go up against the American troops, like I always say, because the 30-round magazine and that intermediate cartridge at close range. Oh yeah, there is a bayonet option on these guns, and I believe I forgot to mention that for the American faction. You see, you can middle mouse click and bayonet with things. You can also charge. He doesn't really say anything right now, but let's set this guy down. Okay, that doesn't do anything either, just like the claymore or explosives. But you can see this rifle. This rifle is gonna destroy him. Let's be honest. This is gonna be what wins you the game. You may not have napalm strikes or anything like that, but you do have AK-47. So yeah, let's take a look at the SKS. Now this rifle is actually really cool, and I believe that this is a Chinese pattern. These may be Russian rifles, but gotta be. There was a lot of Chinese copies or clones, I should say, in the hands of NVA troops. So this shoots the 7.62 by 39 cartridges as well out of an internal 10-round magazine. As you can see, it's a lot more controllable. It does not select fire like the AK is, and it is fed by stripper clips. It's a very cool little, it's not really a carbine. I guess it is a carbine. Very cool rifle slash carbine. You can see, very capable of reaching out to long range as well as being able to just dump around. So let's dump this magazine as fast as we can and see what comes of it. Very cool, actually. Very cool. I believe I forgot to show the Type 67 grenade here, which is a stick grenade armed by pulling the fuse out of the bottom. It seems to be just as capable as the M67 pineapple grenades. I don't know if I want to look at it because of the frag, but yeah, let's take a look at these bungee traps now. These things are going to be pretty deadly. I have stepped in a few of these here playing this game online so far, and I gotta say, oh wait, yeah. So it's a shovel, and you just take a look at the ground here, and you can see that there's a little green option that shows up. We'll dig it up right here. And unfortunately, I don't think I can set off this trap, but we can take a look at it. There it is. That's the finished bungee trap. How deadly is that? You will never see this unless you are like absolutely looking hard for it, and this will kill you. So, yeah, good luck as the US trying to find these if there's a really skilled person out there placing these bungee traps. Let's take a look at the next weapon here, which is the Mosin-Nagant 9130 rifle. And this is an iconic Russian firearm from like early 1900s. Very cool rifle. Or late 1800s, I should say. I don't know what I'm saying. Very capable carbine, shooting the 50, 762 by 54R. That's what it is. Fed from a 5-round Sturm clip with an internal magazine. Very cool rifle. Very iconic. I don't really see myself using this very much inside the game, just because bolt action is a regular rifleman. But as you can see, you can definitely drill down targets there at range, and it's a very capable at range rifle. Yeah, look at that. Nailing that. Very cool. Let's take a look at the next class, which is our Scout class. He's going to be equipped with a Papush, or PPSH 41, a MAT 49 SMG, which actually I've never seen before, and the IZH 43 hunting shotgun, which is a double barrel. So we'll start with the Russian PPSH 41. We are also equipped with tripwire traps and RGD-1 smoke grenades, which are Russian issue. So this is going to be a 9x18 submachine gun, which actually recoil is very manageable, as you can see. Fed by a magazine. And, you know, I'm not really sure what the capacity is on this magazine. And this, look at that. You actually, like, flip it back, you do it with your right hand. Flip it forwards, you do it with your left hand. It is select fire, which is very cool. Let's do some single auto or semi-auto. Look at that, just dropping them. Oh, I'm really hoping there. We're not going to try that. Very cool. Let's dump a mag here into these targets. See how well we can do. I like the reload animation. Very cool. Very capable little SMG. Now let's take a look at the equipment. You'll see that the RGD-1 smoke grenades are just as capable as the American ones, with a similar deployment time and a similar, I guess, deployment radius. It's just as effective. It's white smoke. I mean, what do you want to say? So now we've got this tripwire trap. Let's try to put it up across this area here. You can see we get a little green option here. We'll dig this up. So we place down the frag grenade first. We will go across to here. Actually, you can see our little range where we can place the tripwire. Well, let's just do it across here for now. I'm going to dig this into here. There it is. And it looks like we get another one. Now, if you don't know about this, is a very simple type booby trap where you get a... It looks like that's just a tin can. You stick the grenade in with a trip line connected to the pin. And as someone walks through... No, it's not going to work for me because I placed it. Which is a good thing, I guess. You can't really team kill with these. But as someone walks through, they pull the pin out of the grenade, the spoon releases, and it detonates the grenade on them. Very basic, very, pretty deadly trap if you're not watching out for it. Let's place another one here. Let's see what it looks like at the range here. There it is. That's a long tripwire. Imagine, running through the jungles. That's all you get to see right there. That's all you get to see. Very cool. I can see this actually being very dead. Oh, it looks like it took up our last trap, so maybe we can only place one at a time. I guess that's probably a good thing. Let's change to the MAT 49 SMG. Take a look at this. Now this looks like it's... I really don't know what this gun is. It's stamped metal. It's probably a 9x18 cartridge. Oh, you can hear the reset of the trigger. Very big magazine. Kind of cool. That magazine well, though, is kind of silly looking, but this could be just about as capable as the Papush. Very cool little carbine. I wonder, actually, if I range up. Oh, look at that. As you can see, maybe not right now, at that rear sight, if you scroll up, you can actually flip up the other type sight. You take a look at that while I'm reloading. Very cool. So 50 and 100 meters. Well, let's take a look at the Ithaca, or not the Ithaca, the IZH-43 hunting shotgun. And it looks like this is going to be... Oh, you can change! Oh my gosh. This is blowing my mind right now. Absolutely blowing my mind. So this is a long barrel, maybe about 16 inches. Ooh. Very beefy sounding. I would imagine this is a very powerful shotgun, and I wonder how it compares to the Ithaca in terms of distance. I imagine it's probably maybe a little bit tighter spread than the Ithaca. This is with buckshot, by the way. I was able to hit that target out there. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. What is that? That's like 200 meters? Yeah, who needs a sniper rifle when you just got a fucking double barrel shotgun with buckshot? Let's take a look at the slugs for it. Dead. Very dead. These huge slugs. Very scary indeed. Alright, now let's try to reach out and pick off that one guy there. That's gonna be difficult. Down and to the left. And it looks like you can have both ammo types, both the double lot buck and the 1 ounce slug. Very, very intimidating shotgun indeed, actually. Now that I know that, that's going to be very interesting. Now we're going to take a look at the machine gunner, equipped with the RPD light machine gun and the DP-28, both very famous for their service in the Russian army. Very cool. You see, belt fed, probably the 7.62 by 54R. Very common cartridge for the Russian larger medium machine guns. I believe that's what the DKM fires. As you can see, it is a very capable light machine gun. Minimal recoil. And you can range up, scrolling up and down with the slider on the other side. We'll reload this and cover. Very cool looking animation, very smooth. As you can see, we got a lot of mirage on the barrel now because of the sustained firing. And it doesn't look like, yeah. So the mirage is gonna be pretty bad here. You fire it off. You can see we get a little warning down there, barrel is hot and will warp soon. I wonder what will it do if it warps? My accuracy is probably going to go. So let's just keep dumping rounds. Barrel is warped. Still works. That's all of our ammo. But still works. As you can see, we've got a TT-33 pistol, which should be a 9x18. Very capable little... kind of underpowered cartridge for the pistol, and I imagine that it'll probably take you one or two more shots to take down the 1911 as the 45 ACP. But much tighter sights on the front there, that blade sight, much better than that on the 1911. So, very capable little pistol. Let's switch classes. Oh, actually, let's switch to the DP-28 machine gun. How could I forget? So now this is a very popular, well, very... famous Russian light machine gun, and I imagine it shoots the 7.62x54R. I haven't really looked that up, I may be wrong, but I can't imagine any other caliber that it would shoot. And it is a kind of disc-bed pizza gun, if you go that far. And you can actually count the amount of rounds that we have left in the magazine by where that little loophole is on the top as it spins around. The reload. Kind of hard to see while in cover. We'll take another look at that. We'll bump this magazine here. Alright, let's take a look at it. Kind of hard to see the reload. It's either too high or too low. You see, you can range out the drum there. The rear sight slides back and forth. Looks like you... very optimistic 1,500 meters for this gun. But, I guess you could do indirect fire with it. very cool. Let's take a look at the next class, which is going to be our sniper class. And I'm sure everyone's going to be excited for this. There is the SVD sniper rifle. Let's take a look. So this is a 7.62x54R, which, like I said, very common cartridge for the Russian weapons. And very beefy sounding. Very satisfying to shoot. Very easy to just knock down these targets. Besides for the wobble. I don't know if I like the wobble very much. In games in the past, you used to be able to kind of... It would just kind of go around in like figure eights. But this is more of like a... Like, I'm not touching the keyboard or the mouse right now. This is just what your guy does when he's breathing. And it's very staticky. It's very choppy. Very hard to predict. This is me holding the breath. Still holding my breath. It's very difficult to get on target. As you can see, I should have. Oh, man. Come on. Come on, Rebel. You can do it. That was sad. I apologize for that. Actually, here, I think one thing that you can do with this is if you press... No, there is a way to switch to the backup site, but it's not 6, which would be the alternate fire for... Interesting. There is a way to switch to it. I'll have to look it up for you. But let's take a look at the next sniper rifle, which is going to be our 9130, the PU sniper rifle, which is our Mosin Nagant again, but the PU variant. You see a very clean optic, and it's a T-style with the chevron at the very top of it. And as you range up and down, the reticle moves, but not the sight. Very cool. Again, 7.62x54, very beefy caliber, very beefy round. More powerful than the NATO 7.62x51. That breath. There we go. I was able to down that guy. I wonder if that's... Maybe with the SVD, it gets a little bit worse. Not sure. But yeah, this is a lot more manageable. I wonder if that would be the trade-off, why you would take the bolt action over the Dragunov. Maybe more long range is more effective. So let's change our role here to the Sapper. And we've already taken a look at these guns, but let's look at his equipment here, which is the MD-82 Mine. And these things are pretty cool. We'll take the Papush. The MD-82, looks like you get... Probably, you get 5 of these things. Look how tiny it is in the ground there. Now, let me show you how scary this is. I'll try placing it under there here in a second. That's it. That's your mine. That is an anti-personnel mine. And look how tiny that is. That will kill you if you walk over it. Let's try... Can we place it in grass? Look at that. You will never, as an American, you'll never be able to see that. And that is why... That is why the this faction will be so effective, even though it doesn't have air power like helicopters or Hueys or anything like that. It's because they can place mines like that. And it is dirty, and that's just the way the game is played. Let's try to place it underneath this cardboard here. Oh my gosh. Yeah, that's going to give you a bad day. Look at that. I bet you if you were to step on top of the cardboard as an American, you would have a very bad day. Let's take a look at our RPG class. Again, you get an SKS and the hunting shotgun, which is actually very cool. So, RPG 7. It looks like we've got heat rounds on top of here. Let's take a look at this again. There is no way to change your ammo type, so it doesn't look like there's going to be HE or anything like that. But let's go ahead and scope in. We'll take this medium range target out here. Very cool. It's actually, the rocket fires very quickly, which that's the way it's supposed to in real life. And scrolling up and down moves this rear sight up and down, and you can see there in the iron sight what range you are at, and it's at 100 meter increments. Let's hit the tree line back there. Let's do 300 meters. And you can see it doesn't fly straight. It actually goes back and forth. And unfortunately, I don't really like the sound effect for it. It sounds kind of like a Chinese firecracker. That is not the way that they sound like in real life, which is more of a whoosh noise. Let's get some more ammo for that. Let's hit some buildings. I have to change class and then back, it looks like. Let's hit one of these buildings here and see what type of explosion it gives us. So this is a heat rocket, not an HE rocket, and I'm not sure what the effectiveness is going to be for... Interesting. I'm not sure what the effectiveness is going to be against infantry, but it's definitely worth checking out in the future. Probably very scary to get shot at with these nonetheless. Lastly, we have the commander, equipped with the SKS and the MAT-49 SMG. The sidearm is going to be the TT-33 as well, and he gets RGD-1 smoke and binos. He doesn't get the purple smoke like the US commander does. So, you can see, we got a little radio symbol here. I don't think that we're going to be able to call in anything, but let's take a look at what the NVA commander gets. We'll kind of run over here to the radio. I think they get just mortars and maybe some larger caliber artillery. I'm pressing F for the commander's radio. Hello? Very interesting. Maybe it's just because the range, it won't let me do NVA call-ins right now. We're gonna try these targets out here again. But I would imagine it's probably just mortars and larger type artillery. Well, that was cool. Oh, okay, so the internal magazine on the SKS has this kind of triangle-shaped internal magazine on the very bottom of it, and it looks like you reload it without... Yeah, so you dump the remaining rounds inside of the internal magazine out the bottom, and then you feed in a new stripper clip. I believe that you just lose those rounds that you dumped on the ground, which is pretty cool, actually. Or is it just a red thing? Yeah, it's just a red thing. Well, thank you guys for joining us today. Thank you guys for checking out my channel. Make sure you stay tuned in because I'm going to be releasing a video on the helicopters for the Americans. And I imagine that'll be pretty cool because I haven't messed around with them too much. So thank you guys for joining me today. And I'll catch you in the next one. Peace.